Welcome, everyone, and happy holidays. You are tuned into Ice Cold TV News. I'm your media correspondent, Jasmine Rowland, and I'm here in front of Constellation Field, in front of one, what it says to be one of the biggest holiday light shows in all the land. And I'm standing with Ryan Posner, Director of Media Relations. How are you?
Doing good tonight. Yeah, it's cold, nice and cold. Get the jacket on. I'm feeling good tonight.
It feels like Christmas, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, I love it.
Even in the midst of a pandemic.
Yes, I know. Yeah, we're wearing masks. So
masks.
Exactly, right?
We're wearing masks in an interview. How awkward is that? So, like I said, this is said to be one of the biggest, most fascinating light shows in all the land. That's a pretty huge description. Could you kind of tell us what's going on here? Give the people some insight. I know this is the 7th annual light show, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we're a baseball field, but during December we kind of transform into a light show. Over 3.5 million lights here. We've got a carnival, tons of theme nights, Santa Claus is here, we got food and beverage. It's one of those things where, like, you know, Houston is, there's so many people living here, and there's, especially during the pandemic, everyone's kind of looking for something to bring their families to safely and to do during the holidays. And we hope that we can kind of be that place for people to come out here and have a good time and just relax, knowing that everyone has to wear a mask, it's all socially distant, and, you know, you can bring your family here, have a good time in this crazy year.
And that's amazing. You mentioned the word safety, because I know a lot of people are super cautious. I know it's spiking in increasing numbers with this COVID situation and pandemic. So you mentioned a few of the COVID restrictions already. What other COVID restrictions are you guys, you know, sustaining in here?
Sure. I mean, like, when you're inside, you gotta wear a mask. I mean, when you come in, unless you're actively eating or drinking, you gotta wear a mask. We have your temp checked when you come in. We have hand sanitizer stations with little kick pumps all over the ballpark. And the biggest thing too is, you know, this event is kind of nice because it's outdoors, strictly outdoors. It's a walking event too, so you're mostly walking around. So it's kind of on everybody to kind of keep socially distant, but we have tons of security. I mean, if you're not wearing your mask, security's gonna get on you. It's already happened. I've seen it happen to a few people. So, you know, that's a big thing as well. We're just trying to make it as safe and friendly as possible. Our baseball team actually had a baseball season this year with fans too. Okay. Thankfully being in Texas. So we have an idea of kind of what it takes to do it safely.
The Skeeters, right?
The Strickland Skeeters. Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate that. Yeah. We know how to do it safely. You know, and that's the most important thing. We want to have a good time. Have fun, let families be here, but it's got to be with a mask on, tons of hand sanitizer, and keep people distant as well.
Right. Is there a population cap that you guys have?
Sure. Our stadium could hold 7,500, and as much as we'd love to have all 7,500 people here every night, we're at 3,500 capacity, so we're about a little over half capacity just based off Sugarland, and I think that's a responsible thing to do. You know, there's no reason to push the envelope, even if maybe, like, you're allowed to legally by your state to have people in here. There's just no reason to do it, and we're abiding by our community guidelines, and it's so far so good. I mean, and we're getting to that busy season too, so it'll be really up to us to keep making sure we're pushing the envelope on being safe out here.
Right, and I mentioned earlier that this is the 7th annual, and I know, of course, COVID has had an impact on numbers. Is there anything that's been surprising with the turnout? Because I know you guys started November the 20th. Is that correct?
Yeah, we did. And surprised, I mean, we're right on track with our normal numbers, and whether that's surprising or not, I guess, is a good question. But I guess the thing that's maybe a little bit surprising, just from somebody that's been watching TV and, you know, doing and been living through this pandemic, is that people are still willing to come outdoors and do these events, which is it's like a happily optimistic surprising. Like, you're happy that people are still willing to come out and do this, and I think they're just they're trusting in us that we're going to run a safe event, and I'm thankful that they're doing that.
That's amazing. And I think during this time, honestly, people need some cheer, they need some uplifting, they need to feel Christmas. I mean,
absolutely.
This is just an amazing event, phenomenal event. Over 3 million lights. Are you kidding me?
Yep.
How much manpower can you get for 3 million lights?
Well, surprisingly, it's a team of about 7 people plus about an extra like 10 of contracted labor that come out and do this. I mean, but really our events team is it's a 4-person team, and they put this together every year, and they're always thinking about, you know, the physical labor part of it. It's like a month, but all year long they're thinking about, hey, what new theme area can we add? What new theme light can we add to this year? So
they switch out yearly?
Yes, absolutely. I mean,
okay, what themes do you have this year?
So this year, a couple of the big ones we have, like every Wednesday night, we have a movie on our big screen. Tomorrow, as a matter of fact, it's Polar Express. We have like the Grinch, Elf, which right now really is a big thing because people are afraid to go to movie theaters. Maybe this is the year where you come out and watch an outdoor movie. Tuesday night's like our senior night, so if you're 55 and older, you can get a discounted ticket. Mondays we have our kids' night, so kids can get a discounted ticket as well. We have things like Lights and Leashes, where you can bring your dog to the ballpark on certain nights. We have Pints and Lights, where we have local breweries out here. We have a good sponsor in Just Fix It out here in Fort Bend County, and every year we can add new cool nights like Gingerbread Houses nights, Ladies Night. I mean, every year they're really trying to make this event big because other than baseball, this is our biggest event of the year. And you could argue that this is bigger than baseball. We get a lot of people coming to the door. Last year we had just under 60,000 people coming into this event last year. So it's pretty good, pretty impressive. And we got to make sure we're keeping up and making sure we get people to come back.
That is phenomenal. Well, congratulations on all the success. Where can people get tickets, ticket prices? Let the people know, because I'm pretty sure some folks sitting at home that are like, man, I need something to do. I need to get out of this house. I need to get out of this quarantine, bring my family. It's outdoors. Safety precautions. How do they get tickets? Where do they get them from?
Yeah, no doubt. SugarlandHolidayLights.com. That's going to be the place where you can buy tickets. You can get information on our theme nights. You can kind of get an idea of our safety protocols, too. It's kind of a one-stop shop. So SugarlandHolidayLights.com. If you want to come here and buy tickets, you can as well. But we suggest just doing it there. Skip the line. Like, why wait? A lot of cool stuff coming up on New Year's. We have a fireworks show. You know, if you want to stay till midnight and watch some fireworks, I don't know how many places are going to shoot fireworks off this year. So we're one of them. But yeah, just head to the website. That's going to be the best place to get any information you possibly need.
Thank you so much. That's so awesome. I'm super excited. And guys, come on out. It's here till January the 3rd. You get to bring your family to this wonderful, phenomenal light show here in Houston, Texas, Sugarland, Texas. Just 20 minutes outside of Houston, so let me give that Sugarland at Constellation Field. I'm here with Ryan Posner, media head of media relations, and he took out some time in this busy schedule to give us an interview. And thank you so much for that. Make sure you guys get your tickets. Make sure you guys get your tickets. I said it. Ryan said it too.
Absolutely. Yep. Get them. Thank you guys for coming out.
All right. You're tuning to iSchool TV News. I'm your girl, Jasmine. We're going to go inside in just a little bit. Stay tuned.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe